the terrifying seas of their destruction. Then suddenly, high above the pinnacles of stone, hovers a black shadow, like a small rain cloud. It seems to be moving towards you. Suddenly you realize what the cloud really is. It is a swarm of large slun beasts and possibly some kran. The alarm is shouted along the deck. Prepare for battle. Ich glaube, wir speichern mal vorher ab. Safe. Naja, wir sind in einer guten Verfassung, würde ich sagen. Und eigentlich könnten wir uns den stellen. You are right. The cloud is made of huge slun beasts and many kran, a smaller species, but one that is just as deadly. Hanging below their black bellies are nets of full of jayaks. As the slun beasts descend in on the green scepter, a net of shrieking jayaks crashed into the deck behind you. Some are crushed in the fall, but many more have survived and waste no time to attacking you. You must fight again them as one enemy. Okay. Oh. Die sind stark. 8. 8 ist, glaube ich, auch nicht so schlecht, oder? Ja, sehr gut. Die dürfte ich schnell kaputt bekommen haben. Ja, das sieht gut aus. Die sind kaputt. A fierce battle now wages throughout the ship as the evil Jayaks fight to win control of the Queen's Scepter. Perched high up in the mast, the Kran are rending the sails with their talons and razor-sharp teeth, while the Slan Beast have flown back towards Wreck Point to pick up more nets of malicious Jayaks. Through the body-strewn decks, a menacing shape looms. Both Jayaks and sailors are cut down by the creature as it advances toward you. It is a Jakar, a cruel warrior of the Dark Lords. Raising his jet-black broadsword, he attacks you and you must fight him to the death. Mhm. Oh, 16, der ist natürlich auch stark. Oh ja, sehr gut. Eben mal halbiert. Ist schon mal sehr schön. Ja, noch einmal, dann dürfte er kaputt sein. Oh ja. Mit Null sowieso. Ich hoffe, euch nervt es nicht, wenn ich mir hier genüsslich was einschmeiße. Seeing their master slain, the Jayaks falter and retreat towards the stern. Captain Kelman rallies his crew and attacks, leading his men against the snarling creatures and driving them back until they leap into the sea to avoid the rain of swords, knowing the battle to be lost. The Kran leave the masts and fly back to the distant coast line. Our thanks, Kai Lord, the captain says and shakes your hand. We are proud and thankful to have you with us. A cheer resounds along the deck as the crew voice their praise. You help tend the wounded whilst repairs are carried out on the damaged masts. Within 2 hours they are complete. Wind fills the sails and you continue your voyage to Duinor. Ich speichere jetzt schon mal nochmal ab. Also wie ihr seht, wir heilen uns auch immer schön brav. Ist auch ganz nett. After 3 uneventful days at sea, you find shipboard life rather dreary. If you have the Kai discipline of healing, any endurance point that you may have lost on your adventure so far are restored. This will bring your endurance points score back to your... Okay, das wissen wir. On the afternoon of the fourth day, you are talking with an injured sailor up on deck when you smell smoke seeping from the hold. Nein, wir gehen erstmal rein und gucken uns das an. You release the lock and slide back to head to the back the hatch cover. The sudden draught of air causes flames to billow out of the hold. You stumble backwards, clutching your burnt face. Ooh. Fire, fire, the cry goes up. In panic, the crew fight to put out the flames. It takes over an hour to control the blaze. The damage is considerable. The entire store of food and fresh water was in that hold, and the fire has completely ruined both, as well as weakened the structure of the ship. As you stand surveying the wreckage, the captain approaches you, his face blackened with the smoke. He is carrying something in a bundle under his arm. We must talk in private, my lord, he says quietly. Without replying, you turn and follow him below to his cabin. Ja, also es kann ja nur einer von den Leuten gewesen sein, von der Crew. Immer so ein Verräter unter uns. Das ist der Captain, okay. After taking care to close his door, the captain opens the mysterious bundle and tips the contents into his cabin table. A large shared earthenware jug and several blackened rags drop in a heap. They give off a strange oily smell. This was no accidental fire, he says solemnly. This was an act of sabotage. The forward hold is a food store yet. I found this oil jug and these soaked rags upon the floor. Someone on the ship is prepared to risk his life to stop us reaching Durinor. You both stare at the burnt rags as if they hold the answer to your questions. Suddenly a cry from up on the deck breaks the silence. Ship ahoy! Ship off the port bow! Grabbing his sword and telescope, the captain disappears through the door and up the ladder to the deck above. Ja, ab und an muss ich immer was trinken. Könnten wir eigentlich mal machen. Keeping one eye on the door, you quickly search the drawers of an ornate chart table. There does not appear to be anything unusual about the contents. You find mainly charts, cards, island maps and navigational instruments. You are about to abandon this fruitless search when you notice a small lever hidden below the tabletop. You push it and the panel flips open to reveal a small wooden box with a brass lock. Wir vertrauen ihm einfach mal. Er scheint ja wirklich vertrauenswürdig zu sein, oder? Ich speichere mal ab. Und dann gucken wir uns das Ding mal an. Using the edge of a steel rule to prise open the lock, you suddenly feel a sharp pain in your chest. A cunning trap has been laid, and as you open the box, a small needle shoots out and embeds itself in your flesh. It is tipped with a deadly poison. You die instantly. Ja, haben wir doch alles richtig gemacht. Lord Game. Wir packen es mal wieder zurück. So schlau wie wir sind. It seems that our bird has flown, says the captain, pointing to a longboat moving swiftly towards another ship on the horizon. She flies no flag, and her hull is of a strange shape. I've never before seen the like. You watch as the longboat reaches the mysterious ship. As if by magic, a sea fog appears from nowhere and engulfs the vessel. Moments later, both the ship and the fog have disappeared. Eine Kuh start to whisper. Ja, Moment. So. You hear the words ghost ship and cursed voyage, but the muttering stops when the captain's voice booms out an order of for all hands on deck. Only the creaking of the timbers can be heard as Captain Kelman climbs to the rear deck to address the crew. Men, we are 3 days sail from Port Bags. The fire has robbed us of our provisions and our fresh water has been fouled. We shall have to steer a new course for Ragadorn, where we shall make good our repairs and replenish our stores. That is all. The crew seem pleased by the captain's announcement and set about their duties with renewed vigor. Then the captain turns to you. We are about 8 hours from Ragadorn, my lord. My orders are to see you safely to Port Bags and pass you into the care of the Somlanding Consul, Lord Lieutenant Rigger. But time is not our ally, and I fear the repairs may take a week or more to complete. When we drop anchor, we'll have to find your own route to Durinor, by sea with us or alone by the coast ward. As you return to your cabin, the king's words haunts your thoughts. 40 days, lone wolf, we only have strength to stand against them for 40 days. You do not have long to complete your dangerous mission. A storm breaks, a fierce storm rises, and you are woken by the violent rocking of the ship. The floor of your cabin is awash, and the shouts of the crew can hardly be heard above the howling wind. You quickly dress, gather up your equipment, and make your way to the deck. You are soon joined by the captain, who takes hold of your arm and orders you to return to your cabin. Suddenly, as you start to go down, there is a thunderous crack as high in the rigging. Part of the mast snaps. You look up to the sea, up to see shattered pole falling towards you.
Na super.
You dive backwards, but only just in time to avoid the falling mast as it smashes straight through the deck. You stagger upright to peer into the mass of shattered timbers. Pinned beneath the broken mast is the lifeless body of Captain Kelman. Ach du Scheiße. Na super. As you stare in horror, a loud crack fills the air as the storm breaks open the already damaged hull of the Green Scepter. As the ship breaks up, you are hurled over the side and into the raging sea. Gasping for air, you claw your way up to the surface, but strike your head on a hatch cover. Ouch. And pull yourself onto his makeshift raft. If you are wearing a chainmail, bla bla bla, hab ich nicht. In the grey light of the storm, you watch as the broken ship sinks beneath the heaving sea. You are feeling dizzy and very sick, hanging on to the cover with all your strength. You gradually slip into unconsciousness. When you eventually awake, the storm has passed. The only trace of the Green Scepter is the hatch cover on which you lie. By the position of the sun, you suppose it to be late afternoon. In the distance you can see a small fishing boat, and beyond it the coastline stretches out along to the horizon. Speichern wir noch mal. Versuchen wir es mal. You desperately wave your kite clock above your head until you are near to exhaustion. Exhaustion. Okay. You conclude that the crew are either blind or have no intention to rescue you. The fishing boat continues on its course out to sea and, without seeming to notice you, disappears over the horizon. Pulling off a loose plank from the hatch cover and using it as a makeshift oar, you set about paddling towards the shore. Ich habe mich übrigens wirklich Lone Cakes genannt. Für alle, die es interessiert. Naja. When you are only 50 yards offshore, you slip into the waves and swim towards land. When you finally reach the beach, you sink your fingers deep into the wet and sand and slowly claw your way up the beach to the shelter of some dunes. You are exhausted and very hungry, and the only possessions that you have saved are your gold crowns, your backpack, and any special items that you did not blah blah blah. Any weapons that you possessed before the storm have been lost. Nope. Nope. Make the necessary blah blah blah. However, a few hundred yards away, you notice clumps of small twisted trees laden with purple fruit. Ach so, wir haben den Inhalt auch verloren, so ein Scheiß. Wir essen es einfach. They are Larnuma trees and their fruit is very nutritious as well as being sweet and juicy. After your meal, you feel much stronger. You pick enough fruit for two meals and store it in your backpack. Looking behind the trees, you see a white coast ward that stretches into the distance to the left and right. There are no signposts. Speichern wir nochmal. Wir gehen einfach mal rechts. You have walked over 3 hours along this lonely coast, rod when night starts to fall. The land is flat and barren, and you have seen no sign of life here at all. You finally decide to rest beneath the branches of a large tree standing close to the highway. Making a pillow of your backpack, you pull your warm kai cloak around yourself and drift off into a deep sleep. You are woken during the night by the baying of wolves in the distance. Rather than risk being torn to pieces in your sleep, you climb the tree and spend the rest of the night in safety, high above the ground. All through you awake to a cold and rain-swept dawn. The branches of the tree and your kai-cloak have kept you warm and dry during the night. Looking along the coastward, in the distance you can see a wagon heading towards you. Das machen wir, glaube ich, mal. As you jump, you are spotted by the driver. He quickly stops the coach and turns to confront you, a sword already in his hand. Wir bezahlen ihn lieber. We are bound for Ragadon, you there by noon today. He says, his face almost completely hidden by the wide brim of his hat. A seat below will cost you 3 crowns, but you can ride on the roof for only one. Bezahlen wir's mal, wir haben's ja. Inside the coach it is warm and dry. Shaking the rain from your kai cloak, you notice 3 other passengers on board, 2 women and a man who is snoring loudly. One of the women looks up and smiles. We should reach Ragadon in 6 hours, she says, placing her basket on the floor so that you can sit beside her. You learn that she lives in Ragadon, and she tells you, since Killeen, the Overlord, died 3 years ago, Ragadon has been ruled by Lachlan, his evil son. He and his mercenaries are nothing but pirates. They bleed the people dry with their heavy taxes, and if anyone complains, they are quietly disposed of it. It's a sorry state of affairs. If you take my advice, you'll leave Ragadon as soon as possible. Okay, wir essen was. Then in the distance you hear a bell tolling. You look out of the window to see the city wall of Ragadon. The coach passes through the west gate and pulls to a halt. As you jump to the ground, you are greeted by the awful smell of this dingy seaport. A rusty sign nailed to a wall says, "Welcome to Ragadon." The woman tells you that you can board a coach to port bags at the coach station near the east gate of the city. Ich würde sagen, ich mache hier erstmal ein kleines Päuschen und dann sehen wir uns an der Stelle wieder und dann entscheiden wir, was wir dann tun.